Good morning, students. In the last class, we have completed the grammar and vocabulary part of the lesson, The Snake and the Mirror. I think you remember the story of that lesson. And today, we are moving to B reading. It is the poem. The name of the poem is The Duck and the Kangaroo. We will see the poem. The Duck and the Kangaroo. Said the duck to the kangaroo, "Good gracious, how you hop over the fields and the water too, as if you never would stop. My life is a bore in this nasty pond, and I long to go out in the world beyond. I wish I could hop like you," said the duck to the kangaroo. Here, it is a conversation, means it is a discussion, we can say it a conversation between two things. What are they? The duck and the kangaroo. So, the duck is saying to kangaroo that, good gracious means it expresses the feeling of exclamation. How you hop? Hop means jump or move by jumping. So it is asking the kangaroo, who the duck is asking that, how you hop over the fields and the water too. Means it is saying that you hop over the fields and the water too. As if you never would stop means as if you will never stop. You hop on the fields as well as the water. My life is a bore in this nasty pond. So the duck is telling that its life, whose life? The duck's life is a boring in this nasty pond. Nasty means very bad or unpleasant. So it is telling that my life is a bore in this nasty pond, and I long to go out in the world beyond. I long means want or wish very much. So it wish to go out in the world beyond. Who? The duck. I wish I could hop like you. So the duck is telling that I wish that I could hop like you, said the duck to the kangaroo. So the duck is telling that you will hop over the fields as well as water, but my life is bore in this nasty pond, and I wish to go out in the world beyond, and I wish I could hop like you. Means it is saying that even I too, if I hop like you, I would like to go out in the world beyond. So it is telling these words, who the duck is telling these words to kangaroo. Please give me a ride on your back, said the duck to the kangaroo. I would sit quite still and say nothing but quack the whole of the long day through. And we'd go to the dee and the jelly bully over the land and over the sea. Please take me a ride, oh do, said the duck to the kangaroo. So the duck, what she is means what it is saying, please take me a ride on your back. So the duck is asking kangaroo to give him a ride. Ride means a short journey on the back of kangaroo. I would sit quite still and say nothing but quack. So the duck is telling that I will sit quietly, but say means not saying more, just quack. Quack means the usual sound made by the duck the whole of the long day through. Means it is saying that it will be sitting quiet and still, saying nothing but quack the whole day. And we'd go to the dee and the jelly bully, means wonderful places imagined by the poet. It is a wonderful place imagined by the poet. Over the land and over the sea, please take me a ride, oh do, said the duck to the kangaroo. So it is asking to take him to a ride. Said the kangaroo to the duck, this requires some little reflection. Perhaps on the whole it might bring me luck, and there seems but one object, which is, if you will let me speak so bold, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold. I would probably get and would probably give me the rheumatiz, said the kangaroo. So by listening the words of the duck, the kangaroo was telling to the duck that this requires some little reflection. Reflection means thought or careful thought. So it is saying that it requires some careful thought. Perhaps on the whole it might bring me luck. Okay, it is saying that I have to carefully think on it. It may give me luck, but there seems one objection. So it is saying that okay, when the duck requested the kangaroo to take him to see outside world, the kangaroo was saying that I need to carefully think over it, but I need to think over it. It may give me luck, but it seems one objection. So what it is, we will see, which is, if you let me speak so bold, it is telling that, but there is one objection. If you let me speak so bold means frank, means if you want me to speak frankly, the objection is, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold. As the duck lives in the pond, its feet is wet and cold. So, and would probably give me the rheumatiz, said the kangaroo. So rheumatiz means a disease that makes the muscles and joints painful. So it is saying that I will think over it carefully, but by taking you out, it may give me luck, but there is an objection. If you allow me to speak freely, so the problem is, your feet are wet and cold. By that, it will make me rheumatize, said the kangaroo. So for that, said the duck, as I sat on the rocks, I have thought over that completely, and I bought 4 pairs of worsted socks which fit my webbed feet neatly, and to keep out the cold I have bought a caulk. I have bought a clock, and every day a cigar I'll smoke, all to follow my own dear true love of a kangaroo. So when the kangaroo was saying that by the wetness of the feet of duck, it may suffer with rheumatiz, then the duck was saying that while sitting on the rocks, I have a thought, and I bought 4 pairs of worsted socks. Worsted socks means woolen socks, means which fit my web feet. Web feet mean feet that have toes connected by membrane, and to keep out the cold I have bought a clock. Means a coat that protects from cold, and every day a cigar I will smoke. It is telling that and also I will daily I will smoke a cigar. Allow all to allow my own dear friend. Cigar means a roll of dried tobacco leaves without paper around it that people smoke like a cigarette. So it is telling that daily I will take one, means I will smoke one cigar to prevent the cold feeling for you, or all to follow my own dear true love of a kangaroo. Said the kangaroo, I am ready, all in the moonlight pale, but to balance me well, dear duck, sit steady and quiet at the end of my tail. So away they went with a hop and a bound, and they hopped the whole world three times round. And who so happy, oh who, as the duck and the kangaroo. So by listening that the duck was saying that it has arranged the socks and it will daily have one cigar to make itself warm. So by listening those words, kangaroo agreed to take him out. And all, what did kangaroo said? I am ready, all in the moonlight pale. Pale means dim. In the moonlight dim, they have planned to go. But to balance me well, dear duck, sit steady. So it is telling to duck that to balance me well, you have to sit steady. Means you shouldn't move here and there. And quiet at the end of my tail. It is telling that you have to sit at the end of my tail steadily. So away they went with a hop and a bound. Bound means a high or long jump. So they went with a hop. So they went long with a hop and a bound. And they hopped the whole world three times round. They hopped the whole world three times round. And who so happy? As the duck and the kangaroo. So this poem was written by Edward Lear. I think you understood the meaning of this poem. What does this poem tell us about? Yes, this poem shows the true love of two friends, the duck and the kangaroo. Two friends help one another. The duck thinks that her life is boring as she always lives in a dirty pond. She likes to go out and see the world. She says that the kangaroo is lucky who can jump or spring. The duck also likes to have the same quality. The duck requests the kangaroo to give her a ride on his back. They will go over the land and the sea. The kangaroo agrees, but he complains that her wet and cold feet will trouble him. The duck replies that she has four pairs of woolen socks and these fit her feet neatly. She has also bought a clock to keep out the cold. She will also smoke a cigar daily. The kangaroo gets ready and advises the duck to sit steadily to keep his balance. She should sit on the tip of his tail in his way. In this way, they hop the whole world round three times and both became happy. So this is the poem, and this poem was written by Edward Lear. We will see about the poet once. Edward Lear, 12th May 1812, 29 January 1888, was a British artist, illustrator, author, and poet, renowned today primarily for his literary nonsense in poetry and prose. In his childhood, he suffered from ill health. After a long decline in health, he died of heart disease. His principal areas of work as an artist were threefold: as a draughtsman employed to illustrate birds and animals, making colored drawings during his journeys, as an author. Lear is principally known for his popular nonsense works rather than as a travel writer. These show a great ability to use with relish the sound of real and invented English words. The poem The Duck and the Kangaroo is a poem with a touch of light humor. So it is about the author. Here, students, you have some hard words: kangaroo, gracious, hop, nasty, quack, reflection, perhaps, objection, unpleasantly, rheumatize, cluck, the D and the jelly bully. And also I have given you some meanings. We'll look once. Good gracious, it expresses the feeling of exclamation. Long, want or wish very much. Hop, move by jumping. Nasty, very bad or unpleasant. Ride, a short journey. Quack, the usual sound made by the duck. The D and the jelly bully, wonderful places imagined by the poet. Reflection, thought or careful thought. Bold means frank. Rheumatize means a disease that makes the muscles and joints painful. Worsted socks, woolen socks. Web feet, feet that have toes connected by membrane. Clock, a coat that protects from cold. Students, your home assignment is write the hard words and meanings in your notebooks. And see, students, I have given you the hard words as well as the meanings also. So I want you to write them neatly in your notebooks without any spelling mistakes. And you have to learn the spellings of the each word carefully. And you also have to learn the meanings. Okay, students, we will continue the remaining part of the lesson in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.